قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا يقعد قوم يذكرون الله إلا حفتهم الملائكة وغشيتهم الرحمة ونزلت عليهم السكينة وذكرهم الله في من عنده.
Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, when a group of people assemble for the remembrance of Allah, the angels surround them. Allah's mercy envelopes them with tranquility, and Allah makes a mention of them before those who are near Him. That's truly an honor. And now Imam Amr will remind us about the healing and mercy of the Quran.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
السلام.
Let's do it one more time. Let's wake up. بسم الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
السلام.
Much better. ما شاء الله. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى make us of the people of the Quran. Amin. أهل الله وخاصته of His own people. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى gather us always to remember Him. In the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in any gathering, in any group, that we always remember Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Quran, the best thing that ever exists. Because it is from Allah, minhu bada'a wa ilayhi ya'ud. It is from Him, and it's going back to Him. One of the features of Allah azza wa jalla, one of the sifat of Allah azza wa jalla, is with us. That you can recite, that you can read, that you can understand. Subhanallah. We are blessed to have a Quran. لقد أنزلنا إليكم كتابا فيه ذكركم يعني شرفكم. Our honor is in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this Quran is talking to us and it's talking about us. It's explaining to us who we are and it's giving us solutions for everything. I'm not going to talk about the Quran today. I will let the Quran talk about itself. Few ayat that will quote very quickly, inshallah, and see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying about His own kalam, His own words. Beginning of the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would say, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. So Allah talking about the Quran as huda and guidance for the pious. Quran is huda. Let's say it again. Quran is
huda.
Quran is
huda.
Huda, guidance. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying. He said,
شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن.
What? Huda. The month of the Quran is the month when Quran was revealed as guidance. So Quran is
guidance.
Come on. Quran is
guidance.
Guidance, don't forget it. Quran is your guidance. Quran is your huda. Another ayah.
إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمْ.
It does what? يَهْدِي, which is huda. Quran is? Huda. Let's take it as guidance and deal with it as guidance.
تِلْكَ آيَاتُ الْقُرْآنِ وَكِتَابٍ مُبِينٍ هُدًى وَبُشْرَى لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ.
So again, Quran is huda. Huda, guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's not look at huda and guidance anywhere else. مَنْ اتَّغَى الْهُدَى فِي غَيْرِهِ أَضَلَّهُ اللَّهُ. If you're looking for guidance anywhere else, you will be misguided. You will be misguided. Look for the guidance where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent you the guidance. Quran is shifa, healing. It has the power of healing. Everything about it is healing. Some of us here might not know Arabic at all, but deep in their heart, they know there's something special about it. Many people did this experience and experiment with so many people. When this specific text is being recited to them in a language that they do not know, they know it's different. They know this is different. So it is shifa, it is special. Allah Azza wa Jalla يقول وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ. Of the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals or gives us shifa, treatment, healing, physically and spiritually. Not only spiritually, but physically as well. It does work as shifa. قَدْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described as مَوْعِظَةٌ قَدْ جَاءَتْكُمْ مَوْعِظَةٌ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ. There has come to you from your Lord an admonition. And a شِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ. We look left and right. We look at this medicine and that medicine. Look for all the medicine in the world that you have too. But the true healing for your spirit, for your soul, and for your body is going to be in the Quran, in the kalam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Scientific experiments are being made on water that's Quran is being recited in it, and it changes. Something changes in the dimension, in the shape of the atoms of the water itself because it is shifa. قُلْ هُوَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا هُدًى وَشِفَاءٌ. Say it is for the believers. For those who believe in it, it is going to be huda, guidance and shifa. So Quran, two of them now. Quran is number one. Huda. Can we say it louder?
Huda.
Third time. Quran is?
Huda.
And number two, shifa. Quran is?
Shifa.
Do you need more? There is more in the Quran. I'll share quickly a couple of ayatas. Quran being rahmah. Being what?
Rahmah.
As mercy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaking about himself and his words as rahmah. Introducing himself in 113 chapters of the 114 as being Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. Introducing himself as Rahman and as Rahim, and introducing his words, his Quran, as book of mercy, hudan wa rahmah. It is guidance and it is rahmah as well. It has a great deal, shifa and rahmah, healing and mercy. Many ayat are talking about Quran as being what? Rahmah, as being? So we have three things so far. Quran is?
Huda.
Quran is? Shifa. Quran is rahmah, and Quran is definitely light. وَأَنْزَلْنَا إِلَيْكُمْ نُورًا مُبِينًا. It is the light. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَجْعَلِ اللَّهُ لَهُ نُورًا فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ نُورٍ. If Allah is not going to give you light, you will not have light. It is the true light. Go left and right in life. You're not going to find this light except in the Quran. It is أحسن الحديث. Allah نزل أحسن الحديث. It is كتاب عزيز لا يأتيه الباطل من بين يديه ولا من خلفه. A mighty, decisive book. And it is the best of the speech. And it is so many other things. It's a package that comes to us only in the Quran. One final dimension I would have to share with you is that we sometimes do not take this kind of beauty from the Quran, which is جانب السماع والاستماع والترتيب, when you recite it or listen to it. In the Quran itself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about Sayyidina Dawood. Sayyidina Dawood, Prophet Dawood, King David, and Prophet David alayhi salam, when he recites the Quran or Zabur, which is the word of Allah, the same thing, he would have a very melodious voice, beautiful voice, that not only humans, actually birds that are flying, and mountains, and landscape around him, everything, trees, will make a wibi ma'ahu, will go with him, will like what he is saying so much that it will get affected and get excited and get impressed by what he is saying. يا جبال أوبي معه والطير. يا جبال. When he recites the Quran, even mountains will be affected by how beautiful his voice is. That's Sayyidina Dawood alayhi salam. Say alayhi salam. Peace be upon him. Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam will come later to tell us that من لم يتغنى بالقرآن فليس منا. Those who are not going to get this dimension of beauty of the Quran by singing it, literally chanting it, saying it in a good, beautiful voice, it does not belong to us. It's not to be recited in like any other words. No, it has to be recited with tartil, with a special way of recitation, with beautiful voice. And he would love to hear it, alayhi salatu wasalam, from others, from Abu Musa al-Ash'ari. And he will tell him, لَقَدْ أُتِيتَ مِزْمَارًا مِنْ مَزَامِيرِ آلِ دَاوُدِ. You have been given such a special melodious voice like that that was given to Dawood, Prophet Dawood alayhi salam. Before I conclude my little word in here, I would like to thank Brother Bashir. Big takbir to Brother Bashir for putting that together. I would like to thank all the youth, especially the beautiful girls in here that are helping, and the brothers as well, the boys. Big takbir to them. Give them a hand.